Well, we're excited to get back to play some football this week, especially at home against a really good opponent that's done a great job so far this year. So we know we got our hands full. We're going to have to play some good, solid football against a team that very efficient on offense in the passing game and the running game, physical at the point of attack, control the football. Defense has been solid throughout the year, so we've got to play well. So we got a good week of practice, but we're looking forward to get back on the field.
What was the bye week like? It's early in the year, is a little different. I mean, I know you did have a few nicks and bruises, so obviously you get some guys healed up. But was it any different than like you would have one if it's in week 5 or 6? And then I guess the second part, what do you do? Do you watch just a ton of football on the weekend?
Well, bye weeks, you know, two of them this year, which I don't love, but they're there. So we do want to get our guys fresh and healthy, which we did, and I don't like it after 2 weeks, but we did. It's important that they know that we got a really good stretch of games coming up that we got to be really good at if we want to continue to progress and reach our ultimate goal. You've got to be sharp week after week after week. So I think getting guys fresh and healthy and getting them rejuvenated, back ready to go, was important while we continue to work on certain things and continue to work with our young players. So that's kind of what we did. Now we're back on a normal routine and schedule. As far as us studying the opponent, studying other teams that are doing well, anything new wrinkle that we can add that might help us is kind of what we were tasked with doing, and hopefully we can use some of that to help us get better.
You mentioned how you didn't like the really early bye week. Was there anything in those first two games that you saw that you wanted to kind of use this bye week to kind of correct or implement?
Well, I think anytime you make mistakes in games, those are what are glaring, and you don't want to repeat them. So I think after our stretch at the end of last season, losing 3 in a row, there were a lot of things to correct. So we worked hard in the offseason to correct those and rep those and make sure that we try not to allow that to repeat again. The mistakes we made the first two games, the same thing. You try to maybe practice against those a little bit more than you have to make sure that you try not to repeat those mistakes. And then I just know, now that the meat of our schedule is starting, the full arsenal has to be in effect. So we've got to be able to be aggressive and attack on defense while getting stops and being sound of what we're doing. We've got to be aggressive in attack on offense while controlling the ball and running the football and not having negative plays and interceptions and sacks and fumbles. We've been really good at ball security through two games. That's helped us. We always stress that every week, so we got to make sure that we continue to do that, because if you lose possessions, then it makes you're behind the eight ball. So just kind of concentrating on those have been the focus.
Last time out, Jacksonville State's mobile guy was able to run for 100-something yards against the defense. Now you've got Haynes King coming in. He's kind of a guy that's viewed as a mobile quarterback as well, but he's also completing 76% of his passes. Just talk about the difficulty of slowing him down, in both phases of the game.
Well, that's the challenge, and that's where in college football it's challenging when you have mobile quarterbacks that can throw and run, and you have to have a plan for it, and you got to be good at it. No, we were not great at stopping the quarterback in the run game in the first half last week. I thought we made some adjustment. We were better in the second half. But when you have that extra blocker and he's a threat to run the ball, you've got to account for him. You've got to, first off, in the passing game, not allow him a lot of rush lanes, the ability to scramble and get yards, the ability to run a quarterback draw and get yards. We got to prevent that as well as we can. And then, of course, the design quarterback runs, quarterback pulls, misdirection. They're going to motion quite a bit on every play with their good slot receiver, create some eye candy for you, and you've got to know where the ball is. You've got to know where the quarterback is, and did he hand it off or did he not? And then they like to get on the perimeter with some quick screens and some quick throws to the flat with that. So that means you've got to defend the width of the field, and you've got to be good in your perimeter defense of this team. And really, in my opinion, that's what college football has gone to. You've got to be able to defend the perimeter against good offenses and not allow things to get on the perimeter. Make them run the ball up the middle, which this team will. They will. They're a good counter team. They run the ball at you as well. So, but without question, getting on the perimeter is where a lot of big plays happen, so we got to be better at that.
Jeff, kind of staying on the subject of quarterbacks, with Tyler, he's, I think, was top 15 QBR ratings, QBR, I think, the first 2 weeks. Just, I mean, what's impressed you so far about what you've seen from him? And, you know, now going into conference play, and he's obviously played in two of the Power Four and a Half conferences that are out there.
Well, he's done a good job, without question. He's been very efficient. He can throw the football. He's practiced well as well. Excuse me. He's practiced well with us since he's been here. So I think he understands what we're doing and how to do it. And, of course, now we're going to face some really good football teams that are going to challenge him more. And he's going to have to be good in his decision-making, not turn the ball over, not take sacks, not create negative plays, and still be able to stand in there and make throws with people coming at him. I do think that he can do that. But, you know, every week is a chance to prove yourself. And whether you're 2-0 or 0-2, you've got to prove yourself the next week. And he'll have plenty of tests coming up in the near future, starting with this one, where he's got to perform well for us to win.
A couple of similarities between you and Coach Key, both guys in their second year at their alma mater. Played them, obviously, in that opener last year. I assume there's a good amount of things that have grown with this Georgia Tech team so far, but even this early in the year when you're watching tape, is there anything that pops instantly to you like, okay, yeah, this team has taken that second-year leap under Coach Key?
Well, they have a veteran quarterback. It starts there. He's very efficient in what he does, and he can run the football, so that gives you a lot of options, and they utilize those with a lot of misdirection. They run the ball downhill as well, and they display the head coach's personality, being physical at the point of attack and running the ball at you, making you defend that as well with some play action off of us. They do a good job of controlling the football and getting the ball out of the quarterback's hands quickly and being efficient with that. At the same time, I think they're better on defense this year. They've made some changes there. You can notice it on film. They've done a good job, each week. So I think it's a very balanced football team that doesn't beat itself, that will challenge other teams to play harder and more physical than they do. And if you can't step up to that challenge, then they're going to win the game.
Jeff, what does an early bye like this, what kind of chances does that give you in terms of evaluating the depth at your positions? Do you pretty much have an idea about that coming out of fall camp?
Well, I do think we have an idea about our depth and our personnel. We've played quite a few guys the first 2 weeks. We've got a chance to see some of those guys play, which is very beneficial, and it's very good for the young players to get in a real game. In this bye week, we will work the younger players more than the older ones and keep them out a little bit longer and make sure that we're continuing to progress their development and getting them ready to go whenever that may be, this week or weeks down the road or next year. So all those things you take into account. Of course, I like playing every week once you get in the flow and playing football and getting in a rhythm of, preparing and staying mentally intact and understand what it's going to take every week to win. But with this bye week, I do think that the guys are fresh and they're hungry, and hopefully they know that, it's going to take our best performance in order to win.
Jeff, a couple things. You haven't been tested yet, of course. Have you seen enough to feel confident that this team's ready for the schedule upgrade? And do you put any stock in the fact that Georgia Tech has already played two ACC teams?
Well, they're battle tested without question. They've proven that they can play some good football. So, I give the credit where credit's due. They've done a really good job. And the one game they lost by 3 points on the road against a good opponent. So this is a good football team. And, you can tell by watching on video, you're looking at their win-loss record. They've got good players. They've got some veterans. So, yes, this is a challenging football team that we're going to have to play good football to win. And I think that's how it's going to work in this conference. I do think there's a lot of parity. I think there's a lot of teams that can beat anybody on a given day. I think that we found a way last year to win some games in the fourth quarter because we just hung in there and continued to battle, and that's what it's going to be. And I told our team the other day, like, this is starting a long run of games where it's going to be four quarters of back and forth, and if you're not mentally and physically ready to get that done, you're not going to win. So we've got to be able to withstand the momentum swings and hang in there and continue to fight to the end and hope that we're good enough to win when it's all said and done.
As someone who votes in the coaches poll, you just talked about a lot of parity, and yet the SEC has six of the top eight teams in the country in that poll, six of seven in the AP. What do you make of that, and is your vote consistent with that?
Well, I think there's a lot of really good football teams out there. Those are some good teams in the top 10, and I'll give those guys credit. I think that, as you play throughout the year and more teams play each other, those dynamics will change a little bit. But, everybody's got to earn their due. Without question, Miami's ranked in the top 10. They deserve to be. They've got some really good talent. They did last year. They got some new additions that are really good. They've shown it on the football field, some big wins. I do think there's some other crew of ACC teams that are very good and competitive. And, I just think there's a lot of parity in this league. We got to earn our stripes. Each one of our teams do. And we've got to win games against each other. We got to win games against other conferences if we want to move up the ranks.
You talked a lot in the preseason, and we've talked a lot about Ashton and his abilities. Can you kind of talk about moving him when you guys can inside a little more and what that does for your defense and to have him in that spot rather than maybe on the outside on the edge?
Well, Ashton can do a lot of things for us, and he can rush on the outside. He's physical. He's strong. He's got some quick twitch as well. I think when he can power rush and add the speed at the end, that's when he's his most effective. But I do think isolating him at times on the inside is beneficial as well. So we definitely have packages to move him around. We want to try to let him, now that conference play is starting and he's going to be asked to do a lot, I think it's time for him to continue to rise up and showcase what he can do. He shows it to us every day in practice, and we've seen it. And I'm hopeful that now everyone else can see it, but he's going to be challenged this week. But I have full confidence he can do a good job.
Are you pleased with the progression of the tight end guy? I mean, Mark's got a couple touchdown catches. Jamari had a couple really nice ones. And the other guys have kind of gotten the mix. Are you pleased with that progression through two games? And maybe what do you want to see from him moving forward?
Without question, I think we have built the tight end position up, and it is an improvement. We have some experience. We have some youth that has developed to a certain degree that will continue to get better. Mark provides us experience. He's understanding what we're doing. He's doing a good job. Jamari is a year wiser and older and can do some really good things, too. He's very athletic. I think he'll continue to get better. And then Nate has been here, and he understands our system, can block well. And then we've got two other athletic tight ends that have played, and Isaiah and Jaleel, that can run and catch the football. So I do think that we will be tested more as we continue to progress starting this week, and those guys need to show up. And I think for our quarterback to have success, he's got to feel comfortable throwing to the tight ends, feel comfortable throwing in between the hashes, and these guys got to provide us a weapon. Thank you.